When we use citrate as anticoagulation method for renal replacement therapy, there is always one major complication that we have to keep in mind: citrate toxicity. Citrate toxicity occurs when the amount of citrate returning to the patient cannot be adequately metabolized. In the circuit, citrate is added before the filter, binding to the calcium in the blood, preventing the coagulation cascade to occur. Majority of calcium citrate complex is freely filtered and lost in the ultrafiltrate or dialysate. Systemic calcium infusion is required to replace the calcium lost with citrate. Any calcium citrate complex remaining in the blood is returned to the patient and metabolized to bicarbonate by liver, kidney, and skeletal muscles. Each citrate molecule potentially yields free bicarbonate. If the patient has severe liver failure or lactic acidosis, they might have difficulty with citrate metabolism and develop citrate toxicity, which is characterized by low systemic ionized calcium, elevated total serum calcium, metabolic acidosis, and increase in anion gap. In the blood, 50% of calcium exists as ionized calcium, 41% exists as protein-bound calcium, and the remaining 9% is anion-bound calcium. The accumulation of citrate in the blood causes systemic ionized calcium in the blood to fall, while the bound fraction of calcium rises. And if the calcium infusion is increased to correct the low ionized calcium, the total calcium will rise while the ionized calcium remains low. Citrate toxicity is slightly when the ratio of total serum calcium to ionized calcium concentration exceeds 2.5. The correct management is to reduce or stop the citrate infusion, increase dialysate flow weight to increase citrate loss, and also to increase the calcium infusion to correct the ionized hypocalcemia.